Yes, sister.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, Dr. Zakir and everyone present here tonight. My name is Suhaila. I'm an insurance manager. I work for AM General Insurance Kuala Terengganu branch. My question is a little bit off the topic. It's regarding, we know our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was sent as the last and final messenger and as a seal to those other prophets that were sent before him, and that he was meant for all of human race, whereby the prophets before him, they were meant for their particular groups of people, for their particular periods of times respectively. But we also know that during the times of these prophets and the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself, there were people who lived in different parts of the world who had no idea of the preachings of these prophets. So they had no idea that there's only one true supreme ruler of the whole of universe and beyond. There is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the only religion acceptable in the sight of him is Islam. And even today we have people like the Sentinelis, the people who live in very remote places on the Pacific Islands, the central Amazon, or anywhere at all that's far from civilizations, from information, from technology and all that. So to say that they will have to burn in hell for innocently not knowing the existence of this very beautiful religion, it is unfair.
Sister, I've got your question. The speech time is over.
Yes.
You have already said 7-8 sentences. And I think you did not hear the question asked earlier by the sister. Your question is a repetition. She asked a question earlier that my non-Muslim friend, if they follow their scriptures and if they don't follow Islam, will they go to hell? And I gave the answer is going to be the same. Even if they don't get the message, Allah gives the message directly. It's mentioned in Surah Fusilat, chapter number 41, verse number 53. Sanurim ayatina fil afaqi wa fi anfusihim hatta yatabayyana annahu al-haq. Soon we shall show them our signs in the furthest regions of the horizons and into the soul until this is made evident that this is the truth. So Allah will put into every human being the knowledge of Islam. Even if you and I don't tell him, Allah will do it. That's the reason on the day of judgment, no non-Muslim will ever object to the mercy of Allah. And our beloved Prophet said, every child is born in Deen al-Fitr. He's born in the religion of Islam. Later on, he's influenced by his parents, by his teachers, start doing idol worship, start doing fire worship. There were two tribes that were taken into consideration. They did not come in contact with modern civilization till as late as 1950. There was the Kapauku tribe and the tribe of the Australian aborigines. These two tribes did not come in contact with modern civilization like what you're talking. When researchers went and tried to find out what was their way of life, it was everything but the name Islam wasn't there. They believed in one God. They believed God had got no images. God had no idols. They did the sujood when they worshipped that one true God. It was the same. So if a human being is isolated and does not come in contact, he will be in Deen al-Fitr. He will be in the religion of Islam. He is influenced by the parents, by the teachers, by his friends, and then he diverts to the wrong religion. That is the reason when a non-Muslim comes to Islam, the more correct word is revert rather than a convert. Originally, every human being is more than a Muslim. He may become a non-Muslim later on. So when he comes back to Islam, the right word is revert. So irrespective whether someone does dawah to him or not, Allah will give the message, and then he is responsible for not accepting the message. Can we have the last question?
Sir, but that's only the first part of the shahada. What about the second part, the acknowledging Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as the messenger?
That's what I'm telling you. Allah will give the message if you believe there is one God. And today, in the age of science and technology, who doesn't know Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Today, the amount of media is propagating whether they believe or they don't believe. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he gives the message, you have to believe in Tawheed. You also have to find which is the last and revelation. So once you believe that there is one God and he has sent on revelation, isn't it your duty to find which is the last and final revelation? So when he comes to Quran, he will understand that the Quran says Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger. Right or wrong? When you say that you passed under 10, when you go to school, you don't have to tell him 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. He will learn it in school. So similarly, here Allah will prove to him about the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he has to find out which is the last and final revelation. He'll come to the Quran, he'll follow the Quran. If he doesn't do it, he's at fault, he's to blame. On the day of judgment, he will not question Allah, he will blame himself. Hope that answers the question.